Hey y'all, we're back. We're not on the deck. We are in the garage and it's craft day. You guys, hopefully at this point or not, I don't know. See when this all comes around and gets out to the public. But we've been doing some work on the deck, changing things up, and we're gonna build a little bar to sit at and use, and we're gonna try to make it out of this barrel. But I don't think it's as easy as everybody thinks.
So we're gonna give it a whirl. So what we've got going on right now is that we're going to put drill holes in all the staves. So every single area, we have to put drill hole, and we're gonna put it in the band, which there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 of these bands. We're gonna just put the holes in 4 of them, and we're gonna see what happens to save some time. Hopefully we don't waste a barrel.
Yeah, I would don't wanna drill.
And we're gonna cut it.
200 holes.
Yeah. But we're gonna cut it. That's what the whole point
is. Yeah, so we're gonna have halves. So we're gonna use 2 halves, put out on a bar, so it looks like a whole barrel, but it's not. Because the deck's not that big.
No,
so we can't take up so much space. So yeah, we're gonna do a time lapse and so y'all can watch us do it. And yeah,
hopefully you don't see us going, oh shit.
Maybe a time lapse will show a barrel go.
That'd be cool.
That would be cool.
But let's not waste.
All right.
So all right, let's go.
Alright y'all, so Amy had to leave to go to work, so I'm finishing this on my own. At this point, I've got all the holes drilled, I'm going to put all the screws in, and then sand it. What sucks about her leaving is if I screw it up, I can't blame it on her now. Oh well. All right guys, so I got all the screws put in, and then now I'm gonna sand it. So next step, sand. I'm gonna sand it before I cut the bands because I feel like the vibration might just blow it apart. I only used 1/2-inch peanut screws, pan heads. So probably maybe should've got bigger, but I don't know how thick these stays are. I don't want screws sticking through. So hopefully this will work out. I put, some screws in the other bands, the other two that we didn't put all the way around, just to have secure the bands in place. And then these are the edges where they'll be. Now, should we have found some black screw heads? Maybe. I'm not a professional, definitely not a carpenter. I've never done this before. Watched a couple YouTube videos, which doesn't that make us all experts when you watch a YouTube video? Like drinking bourbon, I don't know what the hell I'm doing. I just know that I'm doing it. So see how this goes. Starting to sand. Time out, guys. So I'm sitting here from editing this barrel splitting video, and I totally forgot to mention throughout the whole video that a lot of you guys might be watching this video for the barrel splitting and not because you know who the hell we are. And not too many people know who they are anyway, but some of you do. We have a bourbon channel that we do bourbon reviews and other silly things. So if you like this video, go and click on somewhere around here and follow our channel. Check out our bourbon reviews. Help us get our name out there. Like, share, subscribe. All those wonderful things. And also don't forget to check out Graham Co. Go to www.thegrahamco.com. Use our coupon code at checkout, DKOnTheRocks20, for a 20% discount off all of their amazing products. Check out their website. They're a great company, Florida-based, vet-owned, great people. Let's help them out. Help us out. Go buy some Graham Co. TheGrahamCo.com. DKOnTheRocks20. Get you the 20% discount. Check out. All right, guys. Thanks. Back to the video. We'll be right back. Alright guys, so you see I'm getting through the sanding, and the center section was pretty bad. This is a wine barrel, it's not a bourbon barrel, it's bigger. They do bourbon barrels in the size, I believe this is the 53-gallon, maybe bigger, I don't remember. As you can see, this one is bigger than that one, and that's the standard bourbon barrel. For some reason, it's got 8 bands on it. And the one we have upstairs on the deck doesn't have this many bands. When Amy sanded it, it didn't have all these bands, and it made it easier to sand in these gaps. Move this up here for y'all to see. You can see all those different bands. And those gaps are pretty hard to get that orbital sander in. If you guys decide you want to do this, and you use a big, the large wine barrel or the large bourbon barrels, try to find ones with less bands because it's hard to sand. Or you can just leave it painted. This one's painted. Maybe they won't be painted, so you won't have to sand it at all. But 8 bands suck. All right. I don't even know if I'm in this. Let me turn that up. I'm done sanding. I'm not gonna do it anymore. It's got a lot of, let's say, I didn't get it all off. I'm gonna call that character because getting in between those little bottom little bands, it ain't happening. We're gonna call that character. That little flavor for our barrel looks good that way. Better than the paint as it was. But the reason is because that thing was not easy. And I tell you, a worn out 100 grit sandpaper is better than a new 120. But I went through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19 sanding pads. The majority of those centers are like brand new because of those damn bands. Don't get a barrel with 8 bands. It's just dumb. All right, guys, so now it's time to cut the bands. This is the scary part. Am I in this video? This is the part that all the work could go for nothing. See if it holds together, blows up. I'm gonna use an air cutoff tool, and I know it's gonna be not easy because the air compressor doesn't run this so good. It does not sound a highest capacity air compressor for an air cutoff, but this is what I got. It's what I'm gonna use. I will time lapse it because this is probably gonna take longer than it should. All right, so the air cutoff tool worked great. Cut right through it in like 30 minutes because, like I said before, I knew the compressor wasn't big enough to run it. It took a while. So I'm gonna try the metal bit on the Sawzall. Of course, it's a short ass blade. It might not work at all. It's probably not. So I'm probably gonna end up using the air cutoff and just taking forever because I had to wait 10 minutes just for the damn compressor to fill back up to use it again. I've gotta cut 16 cuts. It's gonna be a while. So let's see how the Sawzall works. So the Sawzall works great, cuts right through it real fast, but I only got these short blades. I can only do so much at the right angle before you guys know how these things get. They jerk everywhere, they hit and slide out. So I was using the air cutoff tool to cut a groove and then use the Sawzall to finish it. It still gets off track and chews it up. Looks like crap. So I guess I'm gonna wait to see how bad it chewed it up. So I'm just gonna have to just wait and let the air compressor refill every time after I cut a band or two. And I did figure out how to take the guard off of the Sawzall, so I can use it a little bit. Mostly gonna be air cutoff tool. Get back to it. All right, almost done. I'm not gonna do any more time lapse because I've got too much already and you guys don't give a shit to watch 6 minutes worth of time lapse. And as you notice, the boss lady is home. And I call her the boss lady because the reason she's home is because she's the boss. And she told them at work that she's coming home. So she's here and we're gonna finish this thing up. Well, we're gonna finish getting it split.
We
got a lot more.
We could do the whole thing.
We don't even have the wood to do the bar top. That's not for the top.
And they got pallets still.
That's not for the top.
Could be. Let's figure it out.
We might get more done than I expected, though.
I try not back to spend money.
One, I pay for convenience, and two, if it's the right thing, what you need or what you want or just right, it's worth it. All right, guys, so we're gonna, I got two cuts left, this side and that side. I got half of this one cut. I haven't started that one yet, so we're gonna video this cut and see, because it's already splitting on its own right here. So we'll see if there's a result, the second to last cut. All right, it's gonna be loud, so whenever I do the video, I might cut it out, because that air compressor's gonna kick on and this thing's loud too. I might cut the sound out whenever on the video. Here we go. Split, cut all the way through, and it didn't explode. All right, let's see if we can get it open. Look at that, got two pieces. Smells like wine. Smell that red wine in it. I don't know if you can hear me right now because of that damn compressor. So we're gonna turn this shit off.
Bar stools that I've been looking at online have these bar stools that have been sitting around the house. So I'm gonna see what I can do. I'm gonna think I'm gonna sand them up, maybe paint them black, burn the top. We'll see what they come out to be. But right now, they look like crap.
The barrel heads are falling apart. They're just like the barrels. They're just pressured together inside. And I guess I should have known that, but I got them apart and they didn't fall apart. So we're reinforcing them with these strips so we can put them back into the tops. We're gonna cut them in half, put them back in, so we have the complete top and bottom together. We'll glue them in, I'll get some tie straps around and tighten them up, let the glue basically hold them in for the night. And also, while we're doing it, we're having a little bit of Green River. And I tell you what, man, it's even better than it was the first time. Got ice in it, so it's really floral, I guess is the word I should use. I can't give you any specific notes aside that. It's sweet, it's good, it's smooth, it goes down real easy. I really like Green River, $39 for the bottle. This is something you should try if you haven't already. All right, so I'm gonna cut these barrel heads in half. I'm using a skill saw. You can go to Dad's house where he's got the whole shop set up and stuff, but it's like 10 minutes away, and he's got a bunch of shit in the way. I don't feel like moving at all. So I'm gonna do it this way. He taught me how to do this by putting a straight line here, a straight edge, and just running your saw down it, because I can't cut a line straight worth of shit, and I damn sure can't measure either one. Hopefully this is gonna work. He taught me this. Let's see if I can do it half as good as he did. Ready? I'm screwing it up. I'm gonna turn this video off because it's probably gonna take me a little bit to figure this out. Alright guys, surprisingly, I got it done. Together. Well, I got not together, literally separated. I got the barrel separated, I got the heads back on, I got it all done. It really wasn't that hard, didn't take that long. That's how you split a barrel. So, split barrel. With all the peanut screws held after drilling the holes. That's the inside, that's the board I use to reinforce the heads. Once that dries, the glue dries, I'll probably take that out or put something smaller in there. But that's it. That's how you split a barrel. All right, guys. Deck night. Not on the deck, in the garage. Craft style. We're out.